algorithm. The first one is we can generate the circle by using a second order polynomial equation. Okay, we can also generate circle by using trigonometric functions, and also the Riesenham circle drawing algorithm is there, and midpoint circle drawing algorithm is there. So before coming to this algorithm, details of this algorithm, let me explain about the details of the circle. Circle, as you, it is a symmetrical figure. That is, the circle is symmetrical in the sense that if we plot a point here, xy here, we get another point in here, yx, and we can get minus yx here, minus xy here, minus x minus y here, minus y minus x here, y minus x here, x minus y here. That is, for each point we got another 7 points around the circle, around the border of the circle. Okay, so we can say that circle is symmetrical around x axis, it is symmetrical around y axis, and also it is symmetrical around the diagonal elements. So we can say that circle is an 8-way symmetry, that is, it is used by reflecting each calculated point around 45 degree axis. For example, if we plot a point below 45 degree xy point here, we get corresponding point above 45 degree, okay, above 90 degree, above 135 degree, like that we got total 8 points we got. So we can say that it has an 8-way symmetry property. So all the circle drawing algorithms take the advantage of this property of the circle. Okay, we can reflect each point around the 45 degree axis. First, I explain how we can generate the circle by using a second order polynomial equation. As you all know that we can define a circle centered at origin by using the equation x square plus y square is equal to r square. Okay, x square plus y square is equal to r square. This is a circle with a radius r. This is a circle centered at origin, and r is its radius. Okay, and this point we can call it as x, and the point y here we can draw it by using this equation. Y square is equal to r square minus x square. So y is equal to root of r square minus x square. So the point here is x, y is root of r square minus x square. Okay, so the algorithm for computing the circle is given a radius r and a circle center. If you are given a radius and a center of a circle xcyc, in order to draw a circle, we initially set x is equal to 0. X is equal to 0 is set, and we calculate the y using the equation y is equal to root of r square minus x square, as explained before. Then we plot the point, that is, we plot the pixel x plus xc, y plus yc. Why? Because if the center is not the origin, if the center is an origin, then we can directly plot x and y. But if the center is not the origin 0, 0, if the center is not 0, 0, then we have to consider the center point of the circle xcyc. That is, we have to add this xcyc to the calculated xy points. So we plot x is equal to x plus xc and y is equal to y plus yc. So we plot these points. From the symmetry of the circle, we can plot the remaining 7 points. How we can plot the remaining 7 points? That is, here we change y plus yc and x plus xc. Like that, that I already mentioned here, if you get a point xy, we can plot yx, minus xy, minus x minus y, minus y minus x, y minus x, x minus y. Like that we got the remaining points. Okay, so the remaining, plot the remaining 7 points, but you have to add xc, yc to each of these points. Okay, then you have to increment x as x plus 1, and we again calculate y. we again calculate y using y is equal to root of r square minus x square. Then you plot that point. Okay, with the help of that point, you plot all the 8 points, and these steps are repeated until x greater than or equal to r by root 2. This is the circle drawing algorithm using this second order polynomial equation. Okay, we can also draw circle using trigonometric function. How? According to trigonometry, if theta is an angle, if theta is the angle, if you are drawing a circle, theta is an angle, and you have to draw a circle like this. If this is this, r is its radius. So this part we know that this is r cos theta. This part we got is r sin theta. So this point, xy point, is r cos theta, r sin theta. So x is equal to r cos theta and y is equal to r sin theta. If you are given radius r and a circle center xyz, set theta is equal to 0. Initialize, first you initialize theta is equal to 0. Then you calculate x and y position using x is equal to r cos theta and y is equal to r sin theta. Okay, then plot that point. If the center is not 0, 0, if the center is not 0, 0, then you have to add xc, yc to the calculated xy point. And if you get one point, you can get the remaining 7 points using the symmetry of the circle. And you have to increment theta. And you have to repeat these steps until theta is equal to 45 degree. Theta is equal to 45 degree, you have to repeat these steps. So initially, if you are given a radius r and a circle center xcyz is given. So using trigonometric equation, how you can draw a circle, that I am explaining in this. Initially, you have to set theta is equal to 0. Okay, then you have to calculate the x position and y position using x is equal to r cos theta and y is equal to r sin theta. With the help of that, you have to plot the corresponding circle point xc plus x and yc plus y. And you have to plot the remaining 7 points using the symmetricity property of the circle. Then you increment the theta and calculate x and y again and plot the points. And the theta will be incremented until the theta value reaches 45 degree. These are the usually we used the two methods. Okay, so the disadvantage, there are some disadvantages for this method. The first method that I explained, these are some inefficient method. These methods are inefficient. In the case of first method, we are using square root of y is equal to root of r square minus x square. Okay, this is inefficient, that is, we have to square it, we have to subtract, then we have to take square root. So this is an inefficient method. The second method, using trigonometric method, also more time consuming, because we have to increment theta one by one and until we reaches pi by 4, that is 45 degree. So second method is also more time consuming. So we devise another two methods, that is using Bresenham circle drawing algorithm and midpoint circle drawing algorithm, that I will explain later. Thank you.